Hello friends, in this video we will talk about 7th cranial nerve. So what we will see? Introduction and nuclei, origin, course and distribution, and applied aspect. So let us see with introduction and nuclei. So 7th nerve is what? Facial nerve, obviously associated with face. Okay. This is a mixed nerve with the motor and the sensory components. Okay. These are the important nuclei. SVE. Now in place of SG. That's all. SVA. Okay. So now remember SVA. In place of SG. In place of VS. So GSA. SVE and S and GVE. SVA and GSA. So SVE supplies facial muscles. GVE supplies salivary glands. SVA supplies anterior two-third of tongue. GSA terminates into SNT5. What is SNT5? A simple mnemonic, that is spinal nucleus and tract of trigeminal. SNT5. Okay. Now let us see with origin, course and distribution. So you can see this pontomedullary junction. From that we are having the motor root and sensory root. This thick black line you are seeing, that is motor root. The thin black line you are seeing is the sensory root. Let us see with motor root, straightforward. So directly into the styloid process. Before that, stylomastoid foramen. Then into the styloid process. Then 5 branches. I already told you before in the parotid gland itself. Temporal, zygomatic, buccal, marginal mandibular and cervical. Okay. Next, we'll go to the sensory. So we are having GPN, great petrosal nerve. Then we have the nerve to pterygoid canal, where it is going. Relays into PP ganglion. So from the PP ganglion, we have the deep petrosal nerve. It wraps around the internal carotid artery as sympathetic plexus. Then now we'll see geniculate ganglion over here. Nerve to stapedius, the stapedial branch. Then it has chorda tympani and lingual branch. Lingual branch relays into submandibular ganglion, which supplies the gland of the same name. And here the sublingual gland, here the chorda tympani. Okay. Then anyway, I told you this is stylomastoid foramen. So then this is occipital belly of occipitofrontalis. Supplies posterior belly of digastric. Anterior was supplied by? Okay. Please enter your answer in the comment section. The question is, anterior belly of digastric is supplied by? I have told this in one of my videos. Okay. Please let me know your answer in the comment section. So, stylohyoid. This is a stylohyoid muscle. It will supply. Okay. So, this is what? Origin, course, distribution. And one more thing, PP ganglion will supply the, from that the nerves coming out supplying the lacrimal gland. Okay. And here supplying the tongue, taste sensation for the tongue. Right. This is about the course. Applied aspect. Now we'll have to remember we have a UMN and a LMN lesion. Please remember. And Bell's paralysis, when you're asked facial nerve lesion, please say the answer as Bell's paralysis. In that two will be there UMN, LMN. U is upper motor neuron. LMN is lower motor neuron. So UMN is supranuclear. LMN is infranuclear. Infra means lower. Supra means above. That is why we have U. Okay. So what is this UMN lesion? The cerebellar cortical fibers. So the fibers coming from the cerebral cortex are lesion. That means, what is this? Contralateral, one side of the face you can see is affected. When it comes to LMN lesion, the compression of the facial nerve at the stylomastoid foramen. Please remember this point. LMN lesion means the compression of the nerve at the stylomastoid foramen. So, one half of face will be affected. Okay, the person will be able to smile, but the mouth will be towards the lesion side. Okay. there will be problem in speech and making facial expressions. Smiling is not an issue, but any other facial expression will be the problem. Okay, can see this. Due to keratitis, there is a closure of one of the eye. Okay, anyway, references. Okay, from where I took the pictures. So that brings us to end of the video. Thank you so much. I'll see you in the next video.